Thank you. What's that? Oh, okay. Just one, okay.
Haven't you kids got anything better to do than just stand in the middle of the street? Don't you have school or something?
Christmas break, Mr. Gianelli. There's no school.
Well, there should be. Keeps you young hoodlums from getting into trouble. Now move aside. Let me through.
Merry Christmas.
What? Oh, Merry Christmas.
Good morning, Vincent.
Good morning, Charlotte.
Are you coming to our annual Christmas Eve celebration tomorrow night?
Now, Charlotte, you know I don't celebrate that day. Every year you ask me the same thing, and every year I give you the same answer. No, it's just another day, and the sooner it's over, the better.
Yoo-hoo, Charlotte!
Is it safe?
Hello, Francis. Yes, Vincent went into his shop.
Well, I couldn't help but overhear your conversation.
Why, Francis, eavesdropping again?
Yes, but it couldn't be helped. That man? I've never seen anybody so cantankerous, especially around Christmas.
No, I don't understand it.
I've a good mind to give him a good swift kick.
Francis Niedelmeyer!
Well, I wouldn't really do it. But it has crossed my mind. Anywho, bless your heart for trying to include him in the Christmas Eve celebration. Oh, speaking of the big event, are you going with anybody in particular, like a certain eligible grocer that I know?
Now, Francis, don't start that again. You know as well as I do that Samuel and I are just friends. Besides, he hasn't asked me.
Oh, but I bet he will. I've seen the way he looks at you all dreamy-eyed. And the man gets so tongue-tied around you, he can barely talk.
Good morning, ladies.
Good morning, Samuel.
How are you?
Just fine. How are you?
Fine.
Are you going to the Christmas Eve celebration tomorrow night?
Why, yes.
What a coincidence. So Charlotte.
I better get back to work.
Alrighty then. See you later.
Goodbye, Samuel.
Goodbye, Charlotte.
That man is sweet on you, Charlotte. That reminds me, are you bringing your world-famous Christmas cookies again this year?
Of course. Oh my, that reminds me. I have to pull a fresh batch of cookies out of the oven. I'll see you later, Francis.
Toodaloo, Charlotte.
Oh, Charlotte, you're so beautiful.
Why, Samuel Best, I believe you have a fond affection for me.
Cut it out, you guys. I think it's nice.
Yeah, a lot nicer than that Mr. Gianelli. Man, I don't understand him. Who doesn't like Christmas?
I know. With all the ham and the potatoes, pumpkin pie, and the Christmas cookies.
Max, do you always think about food?
Not always. Sometimes I think about...
Well?
I'm thinking.
That's just what I thought. Never mind.
Many individuals who live in solitude do not appear to be adversely affected by their circumstances.
She said not everyone who lives alone.
Oh, well, sometimes I miss my mom and dad. My foster parents are nice, but it's not the same.
Well, Christmas should be a happy time.
Historically, Christmas is associated with great fondness and anticipation. In the Middle Ages, the 40 days before Christmas were known as the 40 days of St. Martin, deriving its name from St. Martin of Tours. Coincidentally, it begins on November 11th, the 40th day before December 20th. Sorry, I thought it was fascinating.
Why, Maxine, do you find my baked goods interesting? Are you hungry?
Yes.
Would you like a Christmas cookie?
Yes, please.
Do you kids also like Christmas cookies?
Yes.
Here's one for Andrew.
Thank you.
One for Edith.
Thanks.
One for Roberta.
Thank you.
And one great big one for Maxine.
Yes, thank you.
You're most welcome. Are Are you coming to the Christmas Eve celebration tomorrow night?
Oh,
certainly.
I think it's going to be wonderful. If you like these cookies, there'll be a lot more of a celebration.
What are you kids staring at? Haven't you ever seen somebody sweep before?
Come on, kids. It's not my stare. Go along now. I'll see you later.
All right. Bye, Rob. Man, I can't believe how mean that is.
I know, and ironically at Christmas time.
Good morning, Charlotte. Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas to you too, Pastor Jim.
How is he this morning?
How is he this morning?
Thanks, Charlotte. Hello, Vincent.
Hello, Jim.
Sweeping, I see.
Now, whatever gave you that idea?
I know how you feel about Christmas, but I wanted to stop by and make sure you were invited to our Christmas Eve celebration tomorrow night.
I was invited.
Oh, good. Well, I guess I'll be going then. Now, Vincent, you and I have been friends for quite some time, and on occasion, we've even shared some intimate parts of our lives. I want you to know, I care about you, and I'm here if you need me.
I'm sorry, Jim. You know how hard this time of the year is for me, though.
Do you mind if we talk?
Sure, but I really don't have much to say.
You know, if I've been through all you have, I'm not sure how I would respond. God is...
God! Now, Jim, you know how I feel about God. Where was he when I needed him the most?
Sorry, Vincent. You know, sometimes I ask myself the very same thing. Where is God? I see the bad in the world and in my own life, and it just seems he isn't there. But I know he is, and I know he loves us.
How? How can you possibly know that?
Well, it all started when I took a step of faith and began to trust him. Even though there's many things I don't understand, I see his love for me in many ways over and over again.
Well, I don't see it.
Thousands of years ago, people said the same thing. And then a little baby was born that changed everything. The prophet Isaiah said about Jesus, "The people walking in darkness have seen a great light." When that baby came into our world, we were given a glimpse into the depth of God's love for us.
So loves all the world.
Thank you. ships come sailing in on Christmas Day. I saw three ships come sailing in on Christmas Day in the morning. I saw three ships sailing on Christmas Day. And
near to us.
know, the you-know-what-I-ordered-for, you-know-who?
Oh, you mean the necklace for Charlotte.
Shh, Horace. I don't want her to know. It's a surprise. I want to give it to her tomorrow night at the Christmas Eve celebration.
Oh, gotcha. You know, Sam, I've been meaning to ask her. Why didn't you buy the you-know-what from our local jeweler, Mr. Gianelli?
Mr. Gianelli is just hard to deal with sometimes. You know what I mean?
Oh, I know. He got really mad that time I mixed the chicken feathers in the potato you were buying from me.
What? How did you... I mean, where did you... Oh, never mind. Besides, you and I are friends, and I wanted to give you the business. What's so funny?
You said you wanted to give me the business. That's what Wally always says on Leave It to Beaver. Oh, B, they're just giving you the business.
Not that kind of business. The kind of business where you... You... Horace, why is it every time we have a conversation, I always wind up talking about something that has nothing to do with anything?
I don't know, Sam. Why?
That was rhetorical. Oh, never mind. Where's the necklace at now?
Oh, it's back in my store.
All right, I'll get it from you later.
Okay, and we'll keep this on repeat.
Don't you mean the DL?
Why would I want to keep it on a dead lizard?
We'll see you later, Horace.
You people need to get away from my shop. What do you think I'm running here, a free-for-all? How's a man supposed to conduct business with all this going on?
There. Man, that Mr. Gianelli's got to be the meanest person on the face of the earth.
His deportment was quite malicious.
Yeah, and he wasn't very nice either.
I know, that was pretty mean, but I still feel sorry for him.
Hey, kids. Nice to meet you. Yeah, I know it's been a while since you came over for a visit. About coming over tonight around 7 for some peanut butter sandwiches and cocoa.
All right.
Great. Great. Make sure it's okay, all right?
Okay.
All right, see you then.
All right, see you.
Hello, Charlotte.
Is there something you need, Samuel?
No, I mean yes. Yes, there is.
What is it?
Well, I was wondering if you... Will you go to the celebration with me?
I'd love to go to the celebration with you.
Really?
Yes, really.
All right, I mean, thank you.
You're most welcome.
Well, I better get back to my store.
Yes, me too.
Tomorrow night?
Yes, tomorrow night.
Six o'clock?
That would be fine.
Goodbye, Charlotte Roberts.
Goodbye, Samuel Best. Oh, Charlotte, Mr. Best.
I think they make a great couple.
Yeah, I guess.
The evidence of attraction between these two individuals is most apparent.
What did she say?
She said they like each other.
Our Christmas is more reserved, but steeped in tradition.
Isn't it about Jesus?
Indeed it is, for sure.
The reason we have Christmas is to celebrate Jesus' coming into the world, to give us hope and love. All those other things are just traditions and ways we celebrate, but sometimes the message gets lost in all this. We must be careful to not forget what Christmas really means.
Tony got a job as a construction worker. Izzy got a job washing dishes at a restaurant.
They found a little apartment that wasn't much, but their love for each other helped them get through the hard times. It wasn't long until they found out they were going to have a baby. Oh, they were overjoyed. So that December, along came Vincent Vitale. Vincent being Tony's grandfather, Vitale, which means Christmas in Italian. That was Izzy's idea. How they loved that baby. Izzy would sing him an Italian Christmas song as a lullaby to put him to sleep. It was called Tu Scendi dalle Stelle, which means you come down from the stars.
Just
asking.
Perhaps a study of the scriptures on the subject?
Well, then maybe we can get to know his art.
I want God to give me a Bible, love.
Thank you.
Christmas Eve morning. I thought you were going to be close today.
I am. I just needed to get a couple of things from the shop. How about you? What are you doing out and about?
I finished up the last batch of Christmas cookies for tonight.
Oh, speaking of tonight, I heard somebody ask you to Christmas Eve something.
Yes, Sam asked me to go with him.
Oh, sure.
Wedding bells? Who said anything about getting married?
Mom, dear. I've seen the way he looks at you. It's just a matter of time.
I don't know about all that.
Trust me. I know about these things. And he'd be awful lucky to have you.
Francis?
Well, Merry Christmas, my wonderful friend.
Merry Christmas, dear Francis.
See you tonight.
Bye, Francis.
Sam?
Horace, where have you been?
Sorry, Sam. I had a customer.
I thought you were closed today.
I am.
Then how did you have a customer?
Well, he wasn't buying anything, silly.
What? Oh, never mind. Do you have the necklace?
Yep. Right here.
Great. Thank you.
You're welcome, Sam. Do you think she'll like it?
I sure hope so. See, she's such a special girl. I want so much to make her happy.
You will, Sam. You two were made for each other, or my name is Horatio R. Peabody.
You really think so? I just wish when I was around her, I didn't get so nervous and make a fool of myself.
Oh, I know what you mean. I get really nervous when I'm around the color of lavender.
No, I'm going to regret this. Horace. Why do you get nervous around the color lavender?
When I was young, I had this dog, and his name was Lavender.
Was the dog Lavender?
Now, Sam, I just told you his name was Lavender. Weren't you listening?
Yes, of course, but I mean, was the dog the color of lavender?
Now, that's just silly. How can a dog be the color of lavender? You know, Sam, the more we talk, the more I realize you tend to get off track pretty easy.
You have no idea. Anyway, you're a good friend. Thanks for all the help.
Oh, you're welcome, Sam.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Well, I better get home and get ready for tonight. It might take me a while. See you later, Horace.
See you later, Sam.
We just wanted to wish you a Merry Christmas, Mr. Gianelli, and to do so, we wanted to give you some things.
You want to give me some things?
Yes. We weren't able to go out and buy anything, so we wanted to give you some things of ours. This is a scarf my mother knitted for me last winter. It's kind of fancy, so I haven't really worn it much, but I know it's warm. And I know you like to wear that black jacket of yours, so I think the colors might match, and I want you to have it.
Greetings, Mr. Gianelli. As a jeweler, I thought you might appreciate an optical aid with your study of my new objects. This is my best magnifying glass. It has a 90mm by convex illuminated lens at 45 times the normal magnification. I want you to have it.
Hello, oh, Mr. Gianelli. I'd like to give you something that's very near and dear to my heart. It's my big chocolate bar. I won this last summer at our church Easter pot dunking contest. I was saving it for a special occasion, but I thought you might like having some candy for the holidays. help eating it, I guess. I really do want you to have it.
Hello, Mr. Gianelli. My name is Bobby. You probably don't know me. I'm kind of new around here. I would like to give you something for Christmas. My mom gave this to me our last Christmas together. She and my dad died in a car accident. Christmas was my mom's favorite time of year. It's Away in a Manger. My mom used to sing it to me. After they were gone, I would play and think about how my mom told me about baby Jesus and how he had to leave his father and come here for us. This little box helped me a lot when I got lonely, but I want you to have it.
No, I couldn't.
Will you feel like I'm lonely sometimes too? It's really helped me. I think it's time for it to help you.
No, no.
Please, Mr. Gianelli.
I don't know what to say.
You don't have to say anything.
Christmas.
tonight.
I'm glad. You know, I don't really understand it, but I'm not nervous anymore.
Really? Were you nervous before?
You know quite well. I tend to get nervous around you.
I may have noticed you're just a little nervous.
A little? I was more nervous around you than one of your Christmas cookies around Max. I have something I want to give to you.
Oh, Samuel, you shouldn't have. It's beautiful.
Do you like it?
I love it.
I just wanted to show how much I care about you. Look at me now. I'm all nervous again.
Samuel.
Well, should we get back to the celebration?
Ready when you are.
Don't they make a lovely couple, Horace?
Yes, Artaxerxes would really be happy.
Who's Artaxerxes?
My cat.
Why would your cat be glad that Sam and Charlotte are together?
Because he loves stories with happy endings.
Come on, Laura.
Well, it looks like Charlotte and Mr. Best are finally together.
Yeah.
Ah, the complexities of intimate human relationships. They often delay commitment. It took them long enough.
Hey, what's wrong, Bobby?
I really do want him to be happy.
Maybe Pastor Jim's right. Maybe God will use something to reach Mr. Gianelli.
Can I have everyone's attention, please? Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas, Pastor Jim.
I want to officially welcome you all to our annual Christmas Eve celebration. This is the time of year we come together to celebrate the birth of our Savior and the wonderful blessings of family, friends, and community God has given to us. Before we get to the food and activities, I would like to read the account of Jesus' birth found in the Gospel of Luke. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths, lying in a manger." And suddenly a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those whom his favor rests." When the angel had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see the thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. This is why we are here, why we rejoice, have this wonderful time together. God loved us so much that he sent his only son to earth in the form of a little child, born in lowly circumstances, but celebrated by the heavenly host. We can have the joy and peace Jesus brings by accepting his gift of salvation. Tonight, join the heavenly host and say, "Glory to God in the highest."
Glory to God in the highest.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for you sending your blessed Son to earth. Lord, we thank you for him being here to take the place of our sins for the salvation we have. Lord, help us to be mindful of this throughout the whole year. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Now, just a couple more
Jim.
Now.
Oh, Jim.
mean, it's good to see you, my friend.
It's good to see you too, Jim. Do you mind if I spoke to everyone for just a few minutes?
Why? I guess that would be okay.
Hello. My name is Vincent Natale Gianelli. Natale means Christmas in Italian. My mother named me that because she loved this time of the year, though I've hated it most of my life. You see, Christmas is supposed to be about God loving us, yet all I ever saw was a God who allowed loss and suffering. I guess I haven't really been hating Christmas so much as I've been hating God. A miserable way to live. My mother would sing me a Christmas lullaby in Italian, which spoke of the baby Jesus and how much he loves us. Yet that song and its message has been dead to me for over 50 years. This morning, I received some valuable gifts that brought that love back into my heart. In fact, you've all been trying to give me the gift of love for quite some time, yet all I've ever given is contempt in return. I humbly ask for your forgiveness. I'm quite the fortunate man to have friends such as you. You know, a very special child gave me this music box. It meant a great deal to her, yet she was willing to give it to me. She showed me love, though I didn't deserve it. Sounds like another child. Another gift of love. A gift of the highest cost, and a love that changed the world. My mother would sing to me, O Deo Beato, a canto te costo, l'avere amato, which means, O blessed God, ah, how much it costs you, your loving me. God loves me, hard to believe, but it's true. And he showed us this love with one little child born long ago. Thank you, and Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
want to thank you all for coming out tonight. We appreciate it. A lot of hard work has gone into this production. We're so thankful for Allen and Dina for getting this play together. We're thankful for Nicole, who helped out a lot with the choreography that you saw here this evening. We're so thankful for Wes and Matt back there and Terry in our sound booth. We appreciate them and we're thankful for them. We're thankful for Tammy and all the different people who put in all this work in making the set, Rich as well. We're just very appreciative of that. And I'm just thankful for all of the cast and all of the choir and all the hours of practice that we've had to work together and putting this thing together. And it was a lot of hard work, but we're just so thankful that we're able to do this for you. And we hope that it has helped to maybe brighten up your Christmas a little bit. And and I just want to say, you know, the message of this play is very real. You know, it's Jesus coming down. Jesus came down to love us. Jesus came and died on the cross so that we might be saved from sin. And I'm so thankful that we're able to put this play on for you so that you can hear that message, that God loves each and every one of you. And he sent his son out of love for each and every one. I want to pray for you this evening. I hope to see you back. We're going to have our Christmas Eve service. Jumping ahead of myself. We're going to have that at 5 o'clock here on Saturday, next Saturday. And then we would love for you to come and worship with us at 10 o'clock on Christmas morning as we just celebrate that love that was given for us. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, I thank you for each and every one. I thank you for the cast and the crew and everybody who helped in putting this play together. Lord, I pray that as we leave this place, we will not forget it was because you love us that we can celebrate Christmas. Lord, I pray blessings on each and every one. Watch over them, keep them, bless them. I pray that their Christmas might be merry. And Lord, that they might remember you. We thank you and we pray these things in Jesus' holy name. Amen. Amen. Thank you for coming.